In the summer of 1806, a group of five praying students in Western Massachusetts conversed about the work of God in China. Seeking shelter under a haystack during a storm, a freshman named Samuel Mills looked at the other guys around him and said, "We can do this if we will." They had no idea that they were making history. They were just students who were praying. Out of what historians have called the Haystack Prayer Meeting, the American Foreign Missions Movement emerged. 6 years after the prayer meeting, Adoniram Judson, a native of Massachusetts, with his newlywed wife, left Boston Harbor to sail to India. Stepping on shore 4 months later in British-occupied Calcutta, the young missionaries found they were not welcome because of the War of 1812. God, in His ultimate wisdom, had redirected them to Burma. In the following years, many missionaries went to Myanmar and many churches were established even through World War II. But then in 1962, Burma fell victim to a military coup, and all missionaries were quickly dispelled from the country. Myanmar, steeped in deep religious belief and zealous practice, fell deeper into spiritual darkness. 34 years later, the Lord in His grace found a young man in New England to send to the Golden Land.
We are the Davis family. My name is Timothy. My wife's name is Athanasia. My daughter's names are
Naomi,
Jasmine,
Sophia, Zoe, and Felicity. Both my wife and I grew up in preachers' homes and were saved as children, she at the age of 7 and I at 10, and God used a 6th grade homework assignment about Adoniram Judson to put missions and the 303 Myanmar peoples in my heart. About a year later, the Lord called me to preach during a missions conference at our church. After finishing Bible college, we worked on staff at the church in Connecticut where I grew up as school teachers and a bus mechanic. We ran a bus route, taught various Sunday school classes, and started winning Burmese refugees to Christ. We saw many people saved and baptized, and two of our bus workers went on to be bus captains. Grace Baptist Church of Troy, New York, where we have been serving since 2012, is sending us through Golden Land Baptist missions to reach Southeast Asia and the world from Myanmar. Many people over the years have told me, Burma's a closed country. You can't go there as a missionary. But in 2008, I took a college missions trip to Thailand. And as I stood by the Burmese border, I asked the Lord to help me preach the gospel to these people. In answer to that prayer, the Lord looked again to the Northeast United States and found Pastor Hack and Dr. Bob DeWitt at the Lighthouse Baptist Church in Horseheads, New York, for that help.
That same year, I received an email from a pastor, a tribal pastor in Myanmar, who had 60 orphans who were getting a spoonful of rice every other day. They had to decide who would eat and who would not eat. He began to send pictures of those kids. It broke my heart. I fell in love. When the news of Cyclone Nargis came to America, I literally collapsed on the floor and wept. And I knew that God was doing something in my heart. We're working with many Myanmar national pastors and training many more. We're working with several schools and many hundreds of orphans.
They are excited about the new church. Some of them are coming quite a distance, actually, to join Pastor Stephen's church. It's the Grace Baptist Church of Sweepythot. I've known him for 7 years, and I know he's a man of integrity, a man of faith, loves the Lord Jesus Christ and loves souls. This is Pastor Alin. And they have been persecuted, but won many people to the Lord Jesus Christ and raised up a church here in this community. But they're also taking care of some of the most beautiful young people in all of Myanmar that we dearly love.
Matthew 4:16 says, "The people which sat in darkness saw great light, and to them which sat in the region and shadow of death, light is sprung up. These people have been sitting in darkness, waiting for the true light. Myanmar is the center of the world's most fundamental version of Buddhism. It is also bordered by 5 countries and surrounded by 12, making it the hub of Southeast Asia. We are going to help Pastor Peter Judson and the Molamyang Baptist Church train Baptist preachers to go not only throughout Myanmar, but out the spokes of the wheel to plant churches and to win many souls to Christ.
For right now, people are very open, and you can go everywhere, and you can witnessing everywhere in the southern part of Myanmar.
Okay. Thank you.
Amazing how receptive they are to the gospel over here.
Yes.
And it kind of puts a shame to us in the States.
We praise the Lord for that. And I would like to do the Bible college and a Christian education and an orphanage school in the future, and by God's power. So I need more some of faithful men to work with me and with us and through our church, Molamyang Baptist Church, so that I can do more for the Lord.
Because most of Myanmar's 300 people groups have never heard the name of Jesus Christ, we are pioneering where nobody has ever been. If our gospel be hid, it is hid to them that are lost, in whom the God of this world hath blinded the minds of them which believe not, lest the light of the glorious gospel of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine unto them. We have a golden opportunity in this golden land. Please pray for us as we go tell them of Christ, and ask the Lord what you can do to obey Him in reaching our beloved Myanmar.
My people suffer every day of their life and then die and drop into a devil's hell without ever hearing one time that God became a man to die on a cross to pay for their sin with His own precious blood.
My people are dying and going to hell.
Please help us reach our people.
Hell is a real place.
Will you please help us?
Please partner with us.
We need your help.
Please help us keep our people out of hell. We want you to meet them right now.
A little hand holding mine, asking me, how can I find the one you call Jesus? Every week they come, they ride, they need to find the love of Christ. We tell them of His love. People all around us are searching for the answer. They are lost, they are dying, they're living without hope. That's why we go, that's why we serve, that's why we lift our hands to the needy and the hurt. Hearts are broken, they need the word. Each day we pray, each week we go, year after year, so they can know. That's why we go. One by one through these doors, we see them come. Their hearts are torn, they're searching for the healer. Down the aisle they come to us, the young, the old, the weak, the lost. We tell them about Jesus. People all around us are searching for the answer. They are lost, they are dying, they're living without.
get you one.